Yeah, thanks, Sharon. And I want to add one other thing too, because I think this is an important point with all of that is, you know, when you start getting into cancel culture and this sort of, you know, if you say this, then you're forever, you know, over here and you're done forever. And, or, you know, we sort of have this sort of litmus test of values and morals. And what I struggle with is, you know, the issues that we're all facing right now, climate change, you know, police brutality, police reform, potentially, you know, living wage jobs, unions, public schools. These are things that are intensely complicated. And so we have to give each other space to be honest and to ask questions and to say things, you know, that we may not even agree with. You know, my husband and I do this a lot. We really get into the weeds and we push each other. And sometimes I'll find myself even arguing against the point that I actually believe, because I'm just trying to conceptualize and sort of work out what the argument is, right? And I think we've got to do that for ourselves. We've got to do that with our friends and family. And we've got to give people space to say, you know what, like, let's get into the weeds. It's going to be hard. I'm going to practice some forgiveness. We're going to keep showing up and we're going to keep doing it. Because if we just tell people, well, you said this and that's it for you, how do you move forward from that? You can't.
Totally. Yeah. I mean, this morning I was having a text conversation over, you know, some recent events with one of my best friends, and it got a little heated, and we don't agree on certain things, but I said, you know what, man, like, I really appreciate this though. Like, we're still gonna be good friends. Like, we're still gonna, you know, be like talking to each other after this. Like, this is only a good thing. This isn't a dividing thing. Like, we're actually more alike probably than we realize if we would less communicate.
And that's the thing, right? You found that central value that you could build off of. And let's be clear, right? There are some times where you don't have a central value. I mean, someone who is a white supremacist, right? It's going to be hard for me to find maybe a central value there, right? There may be things that sort of outlying issues where you say, you know what? This isn't effective for me right here in this space. And I think too, we have to sort of navigate what that looks like. But by and large, the majority of people, we all want the same thing. And to your point, we can find that central value. And from there, we work from the outside in.
Right.